Hello everybody, David here. Very happy to see all of you on the other side of the screen. Today I would like to make a product review, which I haven't done for the longest time. I don't even think I had any product reviews in 2019, maybe one or two. And the reason for that was not many new stuff coming out. So all people do, manufacturers do, and slapping RGB lights on everything that sticks. So it's getting tiresome and has little relation to water cooling, which I'm personally find as my personal hobby. So for that reason, I didn't talk much, but I have a feeling that in 2020, we start getting out of slump a little bit. So manufacturers start will coming out with a new product, which is actually related to cooling computers rather than making light shows. But I digress. So today I would like to talk about the fourth generation of EK reservoirs, and specifically about the new pump and reservoir combo for the tube reservoir. This is well overdue refresh, because I actually looked into my old store that I still have a copy on, and I look when this EK X-Res 140 PWM model was released. And I was shocked that it was January 2014. So for 6 years, we had the same product. So it's crazy. So obviously it sell well and it was popular, but nevertheless, you know, you would expect at least something new coming from time to time. And 6 years is very respectable time to run the same pony for so long. But now we have a little bit new version, and it's number of improvement that was done, and I would like to talk about that. I also would like to talk about the features that was carried on from the previous generation to the current generation and still makes sense. So what do we have here? So I have a little bit of the mess on my desk, but this was special meaning for that, so you'll find out in a second. I even have a generation one, believe it or not. I pulled it out of my stuff. So this is the EK Multi-Res generation one. So it was a really cool product, one of the first items that offered multi-port functionality and anti-vortex feature. So you see, but that was about 10-11 years ago. Now we're talking 2020 today. So first thing I would like to talk, mounting mechanism. This is one of the things that I always like from EK. They have the bracket comes with each unit, so you see it's fully assembled unit, but I would like to show you the actual bracket itself. So the bracket, very discreet, goes right onto the body of the pump, D5 in our particular case. And it has an internal rubber insert that insulates bracket from the pump body. D5 usually very quiet. I never can hear them, but some people do. And also if you, for whatever reason, you have a air circulation inside of your liquid, then you can a little bit sound going on that it can transfer through the pump body to the bracket and from the bracket to your case, and that might even resonate, amplify it even further. So this device is pretty much still continuing to be unique feature of EK pump and reservoir combos for D5. Many other manufacturers who has a similar system, they just have direct plastic brackets that attach directly to the pump and to the case, and obviously in case of any noise going on with the pump, it will be go straight to your case. So this very nice thing, you have a two insert coming with each unit. One is a standard one, more snuggy, another one a little bit more loose. Supposed to be more quiet. It's, again, I personally usually build my system well enough so they don't produce much noise, but nevertheless, any feature that has noise reduction capability, it's always welcome, and I really like it. That feature, not new. We had it in a previous gen, the same as we had in a new gen. So going along. So first thing you will notice when you unpack the box, if you ever own the old one, that finally by default we have a top port coming with 3 port right away. So normally X-Res of previous generation has this type of cup, has one single port on it, and it's not very good in my opinion. Why? Because typically you want at least two, one for filling or when you need to drain system, you open up and allow air go in so the water goes out easier, and second, actually it's more preferred way to go liquid from the top of reservoir and supply it to the pump. Some people build systems so they use the bottom portion of the reservoir and pump combo, but it's not very advisable. It's mostly done for just for looks essentially, because what's happening, this all this body of reservoir, water is liquid, will not really circulate at all, so it's kind of stale here, so you only use it to fill it. And in the case of solid liquids, they actually can separate because they need constant mixing. So again, two ports is kind of makes sense. For that reason, one of the most popular accessories for EK reservoirs with pump or without was a multi-port upgrade, which has a 3-port on the top, 3-port on the side, total 5. So that unit was almost mandatory thing to buy when you go with EK product. Very few people using it as a standard single port as it comes with. So now we have 3 ports right away. If you still, whatever reason, you need side ports, unfortunately you still have to buy this. It's still fully compatible. Tube didn't change, so tube the same as before, threading the same as before, so we can put this on as we did it in the past. And one thing to remember, you add at least 1 inch, a couple centimeters to the height of the reservoir. That may create some clearance issues, but if you're okay and you need it, it may work. So this carry-on feature in a way, if 3 ports is not enough for you. Now the pump body itself. So let's disassemble the system a little bit. So tubes, same as before, as I said. Now we have a pump body that attached to the tube. First thing you will notice, that anti-vortex insert, it now has a little bit better design. Well, better is, in eye of beholder. It's better for me because in the past, I don't know if you can see well through the plastic, but in the past we have this huge insert with a huge EK logo, and I personally usually don't like to show logos too much, kind of silly in my opinion. But now we have an insert with a very discreet little logo in the middle of the insert, and it's also has kind of nicer design than just before, instead of just like here the logo, and now it's a little bit better. Number of port change, so this is actually big upgrade. Before we had 2 ports, one in, one out, and that's end of the story. Now we have still one out as before, but we have now 2 ports as inlets. First of all, you have a flexibility to have tubing coming on the same side of the pump and reservoir combo for in and out, but if for whatever designing reason you prefer to go on the side, now we have a 1 port which is exactly 90 degrees on the right. Second, if you use in and out, you still have 1 extra port to use as a draining point, which makes sense. Again, I'm not advising this configuration, but that's something you can do, and it's really nice. Pump body almost the same, except before you have a little bit of shaved material, so to make the surface not round and flat, so fitting will attach properly for the both inlet and outlet. There was a little bit those cut out. Now we have a like big carving that's almost like a depression that we have for 2 ports that close together, and have a little bit shaving out almost like before on the side. So visually similar, but kind of have a little bit going, fitting go a little bit into the body of the pump, which may help a little bit with the clearance, so it's not sticking out of the body too much. So it can be beneficial in certain configuration when you have a constrained space, so to speak. Now, one feature that was carried on from old to new. So again, if you're going with configurations that I dislike and you go in and out from the bottom, it's possible that water coming in, gushing from this hole right there, and gets sucked right away into the pump. So let's remove this insert. Not so easy. Okay, very snuggy. So it gets sucked right away into the pump. What's the problem? Normally, well, when you're using the system, probably it's not a problem anymore, but when you're filling your system and the bubbles coming in very close proximity to the inlet of the pump, a lot of bubbles go straight to the pump, get recycled, you have mist all over your components, and it takes like 3 weeks to get rid of all air. Not cool. So you can use a little trick. I personally never use it, but in theory, how it's described in the manual. So you have a little piece of tube right there, and you have O-ring as well for insulated. And essentially you insert this tube in the inlet of the pump. So that you separate by literally 1 inch, couple centimeters, the point of entering to the pump and point of inflow liquid coming from other components. So that distance help you a little bit to avoid sucking air less. So it's nice feature, but it's not new. So we had it before, we had it now, but this is why you have this additional components in accessories pack that coming with this pumping reservoir combo. Now keep breaking the system more. So now we're coming to the lights, as you all know, which I love dearly. Slightly changed from the previous version of it. I would say that this is a little bit better than before. The old one was more easy to shortcut your LED, and what I mean by that, so if we remove this ring with the LED itself, it covers LED on most on all sides, so it's hard, and it's hard to flood it. Old one was a little bit easier to flood, and I have some customers ruining their lights when they fill the reservoir and they're not very accurate, they're clumsy, so the liquid get poured along with the body of the reservoir from outside and get straight into the cutout for LEDs and get flood. So obviously when you pour liquid or water on your electronics, it's shortcut. So then you have RMA. It doesn't work. So this one, I think, suck less in this sense. So if you still pour your liquid, how it's done, so hopefully it will escape and keep going down and will not flood the system. So it's nice. Second thing is the fact that you're removing the ring, easily can replace it, so you can take your LED, take it out, replace it with something else. This one comes with a 3-pin 5-volt DRGB, which give you all this rainbow kind of effects. You can put any other type of LED inside, and it look like 5mm or 4mm type of LED that is works here. So you can get spare LEDs from IKEA, or you can use whatever else you want to use, and so it's easily serviceable part, which is always welcome. Because we're in a hobby of modding, right? So we're supposed to fix easy things in easy way. So that's all about lights. Skipping on that one. Now we're coming to the pump bottom portion. The design, except ports, is basically identical to what we had before. Pump, also the same PWM version as before. It's sleeved, obviously it's not coming sleeved from the lens itself, so it's sleeved somewhere in the house. What AK Waterbox using, some sort of paracord, so it's not PETG type of sleeving. It's kind of nicer for the touch, but the problem with paracord, especially black ones, that when the dust get to it, it's very hard to clean. But typically you tackle your wires anyway, so it can be not a big issue, but nevertheless, when you have a plastic type of sleeving, it's a little bit easier to clean, but this is a minor thing. So pump the same as I said, sleeved, and this is the actual part for the top. Very similar what we had before. Comes with the two options. So I show you acrylic, which is more popular, especially because people like lights and would like to light it up with LEDs, but there's also, if you want just black, you can go with acetal, and for that then you have totally non-transparent type of black body, which works for, you know, people who want black stuff. So that's what we have here. I have some plans to test this unit, specifically to see, I have a series that tube reservoirs is more efficient for water cooling because less restrictive comparing with distribution plates. So I would like to take one of the distribution plates, assemble mock system and see what the flow rates we have. So that's something I do in the future, but today not going to power up, not going to show you any LED lights, just wanted to highlight the main features so you know what you're getting, you know how you actually using it, the most efficient way. So that's what we have. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this little overview. And if you want one, you have it at Dasmo or any other authorized reseller. See you soon, guys.